What's happening, guys? Good morning and welcome to the channel. Welcome back to the video. So, peep this shirt, I got it at Walmart. I can't hear you over the sound of my freedom. Figured it was appropriate considering it's 4th of July. Well, at least, yeah, it's 4th of July, it's midnight, so yeah, 4th of July. Anyways though, this episode or this video is gonna be all about flashlights. I have my primary flashlight. The wife's asleep, but not for long after I finish all this noise. Anyways, I have my primary flashlight here, which I use, of course, primarily. We have a backup flashlight, a Streamlight Stinger. We have another flashlight, a Stinger? This is a Streamlight Strion. And then, of course, we have on my vest, I carry this light right here. Also, by the way, this is my vest. And if you're wondering why my uniform looks this way, it actually doesn't. I'm not wearing my top, the top of my uniform, because it has patches and we don't want to store that on YouTube. And I probably should have covered this as well. Yeah, I gotta take that off too, because now we're good. But some of you guys were asking what I keep on my vest, and I never kind of showed you guys, but I don't keep much, you know, on the vest, just my body cam over here. I do carry my taser right here, but that's about it. Everything else is on my belt. My taser is the X2, so it's the new one with the double prongs. I like it, kind of, because it's, you know, more advanced, I guess, but it is kind of bulky. But what's nice is that you can actually arc it without, you know, setting off the prongs. In the old one, the X26, you had to actually take off the prongs in order to, you know, then, you know, test it out. But with this one, you can test it out with the cartridges still in there, which is pretty cool. But anyways, again, about the flashlights, these flashlights here, all three of them have one thing in common, and that is, of course, they have an internal battery, or the ones that recharge. Now, with rechargeable batteries, there's a good thing and there's a bad thing. The good, there's no batteries. You don't have to change batteries out. Once they die, you just recharge them. That's a good thing. However, the bad, whenever they're actually, I guess, out of battery, the internal battery, they don't kind of like dim and let you know they're out of battery. They just turn off. So today, I was actually using this one right here on a traffic stop, and it died, so it's just completely done. That's what they do. They're on 1 second. If you don't charge them, they just turn off. And of course, that is the reason why I carry three of them. I carry this one in my patrol car, in my duty bag like this, and this is the one that I use, you know, primarily. I carry this one next to this one, also my duty bag, and I carry this much smaller flashlight in my belt right back here. Of course, because these flashlights, whenever they're actually out of battery, if you forget to charge it or whatnot, they just die. It's always, in my opinion, good to have a flashlight that does, you know, actually have batteries. And that is the reason why I carry this one. It's like a little Walmart, or what is this, outdoor something, I don't know. I got it for Christmas for my in-laws, and I carry this flashlight actually in my vest right here. Just like that. So, I mean, if these lights all happen to die, I have one more little backup battery or backup battery powered flashlight right here. I do carry one more light on my person, which of course is right here. I do carry a flashlight or a light on my pistol. And speaking of that, this one right here is actually from a company called, you probably can't see, it's probably not focused, but a company called Olight. Sent me this gun light, which I have reviewed, and that will be coming pretty soon. Not gonna say too much about it, but let's just say that this $80 light here actually outperforms, in my opinion, this much more expensive $100+ Streamlight TLR1. So in my opinion, if I had to choose between this light here and the Streamlight, I would choose this one. But again, that video will be coming out in a different video, so stay tuned for that. Also, with the Olight, it actually fits in holsters that are designed for the much more expensive Streamlight. But anyways, back to the flashlights. You guys are probably thinking that if I have, you know, this flashlight, and I have this flashlight, and I have, of course, this flashlight, why do I need another one in my vest? I mean, these are not gonna go bad. That's where you're wrong. One day after my days off, of course, we're off for 2 days, I forgot to charge all of these flashlights. So I was on a traffic stop using this light right here, and of course it is rechargeable, so once it died, it just turned off. So luckily I had this one, of course, in my belt. So I put this one away, kind of tucked it away, and I grabbed this one. So I'm talking to the violator, and then guess what happens? My flashlight dies. My second flashlight dies. And of course, this light is in the patrol car behind me. And these two are on my person, but they're both dead. So at that point, I reached into my vest and pulled out Old Faithful here. My trusty, dusty little light here, which of course, it isn't that bright. I mean, it's bright enough. It will get the job done. It doesn't compete with, of course, this. But it will get the job done, you know, temporarily. Of course, I use this, you know, for that little moment in time, walk back to my patrol car, then I grab this one, which is actually dead right now, but I finished off my traffic stop with this light here. But I say all that to pretty much say this: if you're gonna keep yourself, you know, some nice fancy rechargeable batteries or rechargeable flashlights, I think, in my opinion, it's a good idea to at least carry one flashlight, you know, on your person that has batteries in it. That way you know when it's dying. And speaking of that, my buddies over at Olight did send me another flashlight. Not only the gun light, which is coming in a different review, but they also sent me this bad boy right here. Olight i3T EOS light that they just released recently, I believe. I believe this is like one of the first ones they shipped out. So it's kind of like a prototype kind of thing. So not bad. But these are available on their website, which will be down below in the description. Go check them out if you want to. This light does compare to this one right here, except the fact that it's much smaller, and not only that, but it's also much brighter. So pulling the light out of the packaging here, you can see that compared to the one I'm used to having here in my vest, this one is a lot smaller, as you can pretty much see there. By the way, full disclosure, Olight is not paying me to say any of this. This was free from them to review and whatnot, but they're not paying me to say that, you know, this is awesome and whatnot. So if it sucks, I'll say it sucks and still keep the light. But based on what I've kind of messed with it so far, it is a pretty impressive little light. If you have epilepsy, I apologize for making you go into a seizure here. But the one thing about this light that I really, really do like is the fact that I can fit it right here in my vest. Like so. And I can pretty much use it as like an am I saying that right? Epaulet? Whatever. You guys get what I'm saying. The little collar is like, you guys get it. But I can fit it right there, and I can, of course, be writing a ticket and whatnot. And as you can see, I can, you know, use that as a light for my tickets without having to have this light underneath my arm like this, trying to write. It's much more, you know, efficient. This one, of course, would be much too big to do that, and it would probably fall off anyways. But this light definitely works well if you want to have an epaulet light. Of course, it is powered by one battery here. It looks like a AAA battery. And pop that right in. Screw that right on right there. And you have yourself a nice little light. Turning off all the lights in the room. Pretty much dark in the room at this point. This here is the low setting. There is the Patriots jerseys right over there. And the high setting, which pretty much lights up the entire room. This little light does not mess around. Now, just for comparison, this here is, of course, my much bigger Streamlight flashlight, the main one that I use. And there is the Olight. As you can see, it's not bad at all. I mean, it pretty much compares almost to this much bigger Streamlight. But yeah, guys, if you're looking for an EDC flashlight, this is a perfect little flashlight right there. Again, the link to this flashlight will be down below in the description. I believe they went on sale, or they're selling them as of today. So if I were you guys, I would go and hit up Olight and get yourself a nice little flashlight. All of the technical stuff and whatnot, the technical details and whatnot will be down below in the description. Also, the place to order these will be down below in the description as well. I do not have like a discount code yet. I'm gonna ask them next time they send me something to maybe send me some type of, you know, discount code. That way you guys can get a discount. But yeah, guys, the little Olight mini light is definitely worth the, I believe it's $20 that they charge for these. I would definitely go check them out, again, down below in the description. But yeah, guys, with that being said, I'm gonna take off this uniform because I just got off work, and I've been, holy crap, I have eyes, it's hideous. I've been at work this whole time. I just got off, so I don't want to wear this uniform anymore, considering that I'm off duty. But yeah, guys, again, I do give the Olight mini flashlight here a big thumbs up, and hopefully you do too. Enjoy the video, please give it give me a big thumbs up. If you're stopping in for the first time, please hit the subscribe button. I will see you guys in the next one. Until then, Tatum out. And again, stay tuned if you want to have a look at that bad boy right there.